Hello and welcome to Learn Web Dev. Today we will be building a to-do list. You can type in your task in the input field at the top, for example homework, and add it with the button next to it. Then it will appear below the input field. When you are done with your task, you can press once on it to cross it out, and you can double click on it to remove it. You can also add more tasks at once, for example homework, shopping, and something else. And then you can go through these lists and just remove them one by one, or cross one out and leave one, or cross everything out. So let's start building it. All right, first we will need to create our index page. So create the basic structure, change the title to to-do list. Then I will add a h1 tag, and below that I will add a div with the class container. This is where everything will be inside of. Inside this container div, we will add a input field with the ID input field. The type will be text, and we close it. Next to it, we will create a button with the ID add to do, and we will just add a plus. Then we will create another div with the class to-dos. This is where all of our to-dos will be stored. Also, I will give it a ID of to-do container so I can access it via JavaScript. And this is actually it. The index file is done. We only need to link our style sheet. And our JavaScript file. Okay, then we can test what we have, and you can see we already have everything. But if I type anything in and edit, it won't work. So that's why we will need some styling first. I will just create some basic styling so it looks a little bit better. 50% margin, 0 auto. Font family will be Arial. Then we will style the container. We will give it a width of 360 pixels. Then we will style the input field. I will give it a width of 300 pixels, a height of 46 pixels. The border will be 1 pixel solid and black. The outline will be none. The font size will be 25 pixel, and we will align it in the middle. So then we will get our button add to do. We'll give it also a height of 50 pixels, a width of 50 pixels, also a border of 1 pixel solid black. We'll also vertical align it in the middle, and we'll set the font size to be 30 pixels. And then we'll just add a to-do, to-dos container where all of our to-dos will be stored in, and just add margin top 25 pixels so it won't look as cramped when we add new to-dos. So this is basically it. Also, we need to add one thing, a paragraph styling. This is the class we will add via JavaScript to our paragraphs or our tasks. We'll set the margin to 0, change the cursor to pointer, and the font size to 20 pixels. So let's refresh everything, see how it looks, and this is what we have now. Of course, it still won't work, but now we will add the JavaScript. So first we need our button. Document get element by ID, add to do. So we do this by just creating a variable with the name you want to give it. For example, I just chose add to do button, and then you will type document.get element by ID and type in the ID you gave your button. In my case, it's @todo. You need to give this ID inside here. Then we will get the container. The container is this one, which I create a ID for. So todo container, I can copy it. document.getElementById and input the ID. And then I will get my input field, just the same as above. The ID was input field. And there we have everything that we need. And now we can just add a event listener to our button. So add event listener, we will take the click function. And then we will create a paragraph. So every time we press this button, a new paragraph will be created with document.createElementP. If we save this, nothing will happen because we will need to append this paragraph to our todo container. We do this by typing in todo container.appendChild paragraph, so this variable. Then we can save everything, see if it works. Refresh the page, and then we can test this. And there should be a p tag inside this container. And there is one. It's empty, of course, because we haven't specified the value of this paragraph text. And this is what we will do now. So first, we will set the inner value of set the inner text of our paragraph. So paragraph.inner text will be equal to input field dot value. So input field dot value, this is the value of our input field. So when I save this and press add, it will add a test, it will add a paragraph with the text of the input value. When I type in 1, it will add the 1. When I type 500 blah, 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 it will add it. And now we just need to add the class so we have some more styling. We do this by typing paragraph.classList.add, and here we will just add our paragraph styling class. Whoops, paragraph styling. So now we can refresh the page, add 1, 2, 3, and you see the font size is a bit different and the margins in between are different. So, but you can see when I add a new task, this stays, and I want it to be empty when I add it. So it should be like this when I press on this button. We can do this by just typing in input field dot value equals an empty string. So now we can refresh it, type in test, and it will remove the input value but add the paragraph with the old value. And now we just need to remove this. So when I press on it, nothing happens. And inside this event listener, we will just add another event listener for our paragraph. First, only click. So on one click, it should do this. Set the paragraph style text decoration to line through. So save it, refresh the page. When I press on it, it should put a line through the text to indicate that it's done. And now we want to remove it. We can do this by just copying all of this. And instead of click, we will have DBL, double click, and change this paragraph dot remove child. So you know how we appended the child to our todo container. We can do the same, but with remove child. So instead of append child, just put in remove child. Save it, refresh the page, test, it puts the line through with one click, and double click, we'll remove it. We can test some more. You can see I can cross these out and do this, and that's basically it. So if you have any questions about this or some better code, leave it down in the comments below. If you liked it, please leave a like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.